Taurus Paul Kelly.
Yeah. Kelly, Kelly, Kelly.
It's the Kelly, Kelly, Kelly show. Now,
well, I mean, we're in the South. It would be bad, Mr. Kelly.
It would?
Yes.
Okay.
KKK.
Why don't, oh, yes. Wow. I'm Kurt Kelly. We are here with Luis Torres. Is it pronounced? Is your last name Bol?
Torres Bol. Yes, Bol. Yes.
And you're with Mexicanal. Which is what? The network for Mexico?
Yes. Yes, it's a network out of Mexico.
What does your programming specialize in?
It's programming for many of the Mexicans who live and work here in the United States.
So is this a U.S. broadcast channel, or does it air on both sides?
It airs in both sides.
So what brings you to this convention?
Well, it's to talk to different suppliers, distributors, as well as friends and colleagues from the industry, and be able to learn about what it is that they're doing and exchange ideas and hopefully make new deals.
What percentage of the programming that you air ends up coming from the show?
Very little.
Really?
Yes.
So this is more an event where you can find out the latest trends, socialize?
Yes, and also talk to distributors.
Okay.
Come up with new ideas for possibly new shows or new distribution partners or new projects.
Are you finding that you're also streaming and competing more with the internet, or has that had little impact for your audience?
No, I think the internet is prevalent and it's pervasive, it's everywhere, so you have to pay attention to it. It is part of what we do, day in and day out.
Understood. Now, you're with Tim Kelly, and you're the Vice President of Performance One. What is Performance One?
We're a full-service media agency. We do direct response PI. We have content, Weather Nation, Pursuit Channel, and we also have content services.
So are you here to sell your products, I'm taking it?
A mixture. We've got Weather Nation here. We're an over-the-top product, competes directly with the Weather Channel. The Pursuit Channel, like I said, we're in 40 million households today. More of a traditional cable play. We're here selling and buying.
How is this year's convention for you different than past years?
You know, it's not much different. A lot of the same faces, but, you know, maybe some new ideas and definitely a lot of action items coming out of it.
Is the new media, are you seeing that impact your audiences here in the U.S.?
The new media or a part of the new media, especially with Weather Nation. So for us, it is a key component to our strategy. So we're a part of it and we continue to play in it.
Where do you see the opportunities for the next year, both of you?
For us, again, we've got product both over the top and traditional cable. Right now, our over the top product, whether it be dot channels or whether it be direct partnerships with the OEMs, that's really where we're seeing a lot of opportunity. From LG to Samsung to Panasonic to you name it. These guys are delivering a video-based product directly to the consumer, so that's where we want to be.
So we would find even in the apps of like Androids, your applications?
Today we're on the iPhone, we're building for Android, and we're building for everybody else right now directly with the OEMs.
Yep. Nice. And how do you see the next year changing for you in the horizon?
Well, I think that there will be more applications for iPhones and for electronic devices. I believe that as they become more in vogue and more in use, we have to pay attention to that. It is not only the television, where the traditional setting of television, the people watch programming, but it's also at work and just in daily life. So you have to adapt to it.
You know, in listening to you both speak, it brings to mind that with set-top boxes, we have an idea who's viewing. We can know that this household has these age demographics. With things moving more to handheld devices, how do you monitor who's using it and what viewership you might have?
Well, I mean, it is a problem. And that's the reason Nielsen and all of the different companies that measure audiences are having a difficult time finding ways in which they can actually deliver data on viewership that is accurate, or that at least it is projectable to the whole of the population. But I believe that as things progress, they will find new methods through which they can measure viewership. I think it's a matter of time. The fact that we have the people meter today, it doesn't necessarily mean that it was always there. Before that, I mean, as you well know, there were diaries, and before that, coincidental, you know, telephone service and so on. So, I mean, as the industry evolves and the technology evolves, so we'll have to evolve the measuring, you know, companies, the audience measurement.
You know, with our over-the-top product with the OEMs, we got a real-time dashboard. So I know exactly who, where, what. So for us, it's not an issue on the weather product today.
So you actually have a way to know if I have females 18 to 34. You know your demographics and psychographics of who you're reaching.
It gets a little trickier when you get down to that level of detail because it you're in a lot of cases you're reliant on that consumer to fill out a card, right, and submit it. However, if you bounce the data back to who's viewing, put it in a couple of other databases that are available out there, you can pretty much figure it out.
Thank you both for your time. Enjoy nap.
Thank you, Mr. Kelly.
Could I ask you guys to do like just a quick cutaway with your name and your watching actor's reporter? Would that be possible?
Sure.
Your name, your company, whatever you want to say. So we're going to do a couple quick cutaways.
Yeah. My name is Luis Torres Bol, and I am an avid watcher of actor's reporter.
My name is Tim Kelly with Performance One Media, and you're watching Actors Reporter.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Did I get it right?
You did it right. Thank you so very much for your time.